Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand formatted input output. So before understanding what is meant by formatted, we will try to understand what is this input output. So if you take any programming language, that programming language has to support the input and output functionalities. So what is this input and output means? Whenever we write a program, the output of the program has to be printed on the screen, or the user should be provided with some interactions with the program. So without that interactions, without the display of the output on the screen, it is of no use of writing the program, right? So the ultimate goal of the program is to provide an end-to-end relationship with the user. So for that relationship to be maintained, a programming language has to support the functionalities, so that the input and the output has to be done by the programming languages. So for that to happen, C also provides the input and output functionalities. The functions that are used for input. So inputting means just reading the values from the keyboard. So whenever we type the values on the keyboard, that values has to be read by the C program, and that values has to be taken by the program, and it has to be stored onto the memory. So that functionality has to be provided. That functionality is provided in C programming language by a function called scanf function. So for reading the values from the keyboard or from the input device, C program is providing a function called scanf function. So this is for input. Similarly, the content that has been executed, the program, after executing the program to print the values, or in the process of executing the programs in order to print something onto the screen, the C programming language is provided with an output function called printf function. So the output function is printf function. A function should always be used with these open and closed parentheses. As we have discussed in our first chapter, the main function, then after the name of the function, we have to provide open and closed parentheses. So see here, this is the program that we are using it from the first class. So in this, the main is a function. After that, we are having open and closed parentheses. Based upon our requirements, we can provide some values within those parentheses. So in this class, we will try to understand about the output function, which is printf function. In the later coming classes, we will try to understand about our scanf function also. So now, coming to our first program, in this program we are having an output function, printf function, here in this line. So this printf function, what this printf function is doing is, this printf function is printing the value after the sum of a plus b. So as we have discussed, that C program will get executed sequentially, line after line the C program will get executed. Here a is assigned with 10 and b is assigned with 20, and these values will be summed up in this expression, and this expression after summing up the values, the value 30 will get stored in C, and that value will get printed by using this printf function. So how that printing happens? What is this printf function? What are the parameters that can be given within those parentheses? So all those concepts we will try to understand it by using this theoretical matter. So this matter, using this, we will try to understand. And one more thing, what we will do is, this printf is very raw in nature, so we are not going to get any information, we are not going to provide any information to the end user. So we will change this printf statement into two printf statements. So these two printf, now instead of using this printf statement, we will use these two printf statements. These two printf statements are going to provide more interactivity with the end user. So how it is going to happen, that we will try to understand. What is a printf statement? The printf function, statement or function, printf function is designed to display the contents of a string known as format string. format string. So what the printf statement will do is, whatever that is provided with the format string, that content will be displayed by the printf statement. So that is the reason why we call it as a formatted input output. The string that we are going to provide as the parameters to the printf function is what we call it as a format string, and that format string has to be provided in the double quotes. Let's consider. So what we will do is, we will split this entire entire statement into two parts. This is first part, and in the next so this part we'll try to understand first, and later we'll try to understand this remaining part. So what this part states is, the printf function is designed to display the contents of a string known as string means it is a group of characters, string known as format string. So that format string, within the printf statement, whatever that is provided as the format string, that will get printed. So within the double quotes, whatever we are going to provide, so that is what we call it as format string. It is a string, but it is in a formatted way. That is the reason why we call it as format string. So what this printf statement is printing is, the values of the integer a and b are 10 and 20. It will print the format strings, the characters in the format string as it is. So what it will print after executing this statement, what happens is, this entire string literal, so this entire literal will get printed as it is. The values of the integer a and b are 10 and 20. So this information is provided to the end user, and this format string will get printed on the computer screen. Now the remaining part of the printf function, the values, with values possibly inserted at specific points in a string, the string format, the format string is followed by any values that are to be inserted into the string during printing. The format string may contain both ordinary characters and conversion specifiers which begin with percentage character. So let's break it into pieces. So we will try to understand from here, with values. So apart, within the format string, what is the other possibility is, within the format string, what is the other possibility is, with values possibly inserted at specified points in the string. Within the string, apart from the characters, we can also insert the values. Values means the values of the variables. So at the specific point of the string, we can insert the values. Values means it is the values that are stored in the variables. Let's try to understand that point by using this printf. So this is a string literal. The values will get printed as it is. If you want to print the characters as it is, just give them in the format string. But if you want to print the values of the variables, then what we have to do is, the sum of the percentage d and percentage d. So what is this percentage d and percentage d? Is percentage d. So what it states is, we can possibly insert the values at a specific point. So we are going to insert values at this point, and what values we are going to insert, that are to be followed after the format string. So what values we would like to insert into the format string, those values are to be followed after the format string. So let's try to understand. The format string is followed by any values that are to be inserted into the string during printing. So this format string, this is whatever we give in the double quotes is what we call it as format string. This format string is followed by some values. So these are the values that are to be inserted at the specific points of the string, and this is what we call it as conversion specifier. Coming to this point, the format string may contain both ordinary characters. So these are ordinary characters, the sum of the, so that is an ordinary character, and conversion specifiers which begin with percentage character. So these are what we call it as conversion specifiers. These conversion specifiers are to be inserted in the format string, are to be inserted where we want to specify the values. At that point we have to use these conversion specifiers, and what values that we would like to display, within the format string, those values are to be followed after the format string. So here we are going to end the format string, the double quotes are going to end the format string. After that, so at this specific points, what are the values are to be inserted, those values will be followed after the format string. So what happens with the execution of this line is the sum of the, so this will get printed as it is, because the sum of the percentage d, at percentage d it is going to print the value stored in A. What is the value stored in A? It is 10, the sum of the 10. And so I have by mistake, so the is not there, the sum of 10 and percentage d. Here the second format, the conversion specifier is going to specify the second variable. So this value, the value stored in B, will get inserted at this conversion specifier. So this percentage d is what we call it as conversion specifier. So this conversion specifier always starts with a percentage symbol, and d is used for integer. So we have to print integer. In order to print an integer, the conversion, this variable value will get converted into integer as it is mentioned as integer. So this variable will get converted into integer and it will be inserted at this point. This is how the printf statements, the format string printf statement format string will be. Okay, so now the sum of 10, value stored in A is 10, and B, value stored in 20, B is 20, is percentage d. Again we want to insert some value, that value is C value. So those are followed after format string. Value of C is, after executing this line, the value of C has been inserted with 30. So this 30 will be printed in this way. So this entire printf statement, what it is going to print is the sum of 10 and 20 is 30. This is the output that we are going to get. So let's what we will do is, we'll just try to execute this program. So this program with these printf statements, we'll try to execute and see how the output will get displayed. Let's check the output. We have written the program and we are going to execute it and we are going to run it. See here, so we have changed the program. This is for system sake, in order to change the output screen color. So don't consider this. So these two printf statements, we have changed, updated these two printf statements. The values of the integer A and B are 10 and 20. So there are no format specific, there are no conversion specifiers. So this entire string will be printed, as it is. And we have added an extra character slash n. This, about this we'll try to understand later. So now the sum of the percentage d and percentage d, these are conversion specifiers. At these specifiers, at these conversion specifiers, these values will get inserted. So this is how the printer statements can be. So there are no errors. Let's print the output. See here, the values of the integer A and B are 10 and 20, but here in this statement, let's check this. See here, the sum of percentage d, why the percentage d has not been printed? Percentage d states that it is a conversion specifier. So this value of A will be converted into integer and that integer will get printed. The sum of 10 and 20. So at this percentage, at these conversion specifiers, these sequence of values will get printed. The sum of 10 and 20, what is the value stored in A? It is 10, and the value stored in B is 20, and the value stored in C is 30. The sum of 10 and 20 is 30. Okay, so this is This is all about the printf statement. This is how the format string can be. That is the reason why it is called as a formatted input and output. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubts in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.